this entry is related to the salary and outstanding salary, right? Now, so according to this general entry, salary is expenditure, and we can see already the salary is $900. We can see on the debit side of the profit and loss account. And whenever that we will put this $2,000 again, and from the 900, it will be $2,900, right? On the other side, outstanding salary, this is the $2,000 same, because in this case, neither cash nor bank account has gone down, because we have not paid by cash or by bank. Or if it is paid by bank, like by check, but the check is not clear till 31st of December. So this is the scenario. So that's why we say this is the outstanding salary, which means it is due but not paid. And also what we can do, transaction number 18 that I'm going to write, for example, rent of the building is given. So rent of the building, let's say $1,200, which is due but not paid. So in this case, the rent of the building is expenditure. So definitely we will write here rent of building is $1,200, and to outstanding rent of building. Rent of building was due but not paid. So the same thing, nominal account and the personal account, right? So the second transaction, next transaction that we have completed here, and we have prepared the general entry for this one. Now, for these two general entry, I'm going to post into the ledger. The first one is the salary account. Go to ledger account. Look at the salary account we already have here. Right here to outstanding salary. This is $2,000. So outstanding salary is $2,000 that we have put it here, right? So let me see, do we have an outstanding salary account? We don't have. So for outstanding salary ledger that we are going to create it here, I have just a copy paste here, and just I'm going to write outstanding salary. That's it. Okay, so now here I'm going to update this information. Outstanding salary is 2000. Salary account debit to outstanding salary. In outstanding salary, I'm going to write by salary. In salary heading, in salary ledger, write outstanding salary. In outstanding salary ledger, write salary. So this is how we post a journal to ledger. Second transaction we have, rent of the building to outstanding rent of the building. So amount is 1200. Rent of the building is here. 1200 is amount, and I'm going to write here to outstanding rent of building. Okay, so now here outstanding rent of building, I think we don't have, right? So this is the first entry. So for outstanding rent of building, I'm going to copy paste here, and I'm going to write it here outstanding rent of building. So we are doing these adjustments. So these are known as adjustment entries as well, because adjustment that we do at the end of the period, when we come to know, okay, the salary is not given to our employee, or check was given, but it was not placed for clearance. And according to the information we have, so we have to put this one as expenditure, and on the other side and outstanding expenses. So rent of the building is here to outstanding rent of the building 1200. Outstanding rent of the building, and here we will write by what we should write, rent of the building. Right. So rent of the building. So here the amount will be same. Right. So now in the trial balance we see salary count is here. It is automatically updated. Can you see this one? So it was 900 before, and same in the profit and loss count. You see, it was 900 before, but now this is 2900. Automatically it is updated. So there is no any magic. but just a simple Microsoft Excel, and we are using the some features of Microsoft Excel. So now I'm just going to write here outstanding salary and outstanding rent of the building. So we don't have a space here. I am going to create some space by inserting rows. Now I'm going to write it here first, outstanding salary. And the second one, I'm going to write outstanding rent of building. So on the debit side or credit side? That should be on the credit side. Outstanding salary and rent of the building. Rent of the building, I think we don't have. Yeah, we have 2700. This is fine. So outstanding salary, go to ledger. This is the outstanding salary, the first one. And the second one we have here, rent of the building. So rent of the building is $1,200. You can see $73,100. This is the debit and credit side of trial balance are equal. Now go to profit and loss count. Rent of the building, yes, this is here. Salary, this is also here, and it is also updated. But the two things which are not updated, that is outstanding rent of the building and outstanding salary. So we know if this is outstanding something, that definitely that will be the current liability, and we will put here under the current liability heading. So we don't have space here. Just what we need to do, just we need to make some space, and I'm going to write it here, outstanding salary first. Detail column, I am just going to write here outstanding salary, the first one, $2,000. And next, the outstanding rent is also there, right? So outstanding rent, I'm also putting this one according to the information that we have in trial balance. I'm going to delete this one, and here I'm just going to write as equal to sign. Then sum of all these five figures and bracket close and enter, that's it. So now look at this, $59,600 is the total of asset side, and also the same total in the liability side, and the profit is $1,200. It was something else before, right? But now this is updated. Why it is updated? Because of the salary and the rent of the building that was belong to this year and should be recorded this year. This is because of the matching principle that we discussed last time. So now this is how to pass this journey from the ledger to trial balance, means from the journal to ledger, ledger to trial balance to profit and loss account and balance sheet. This is our accounting cycle that we are following, the same thing again and again. We are following these three lines again and again. We are following these things again and again. So just a small, these information are really, really very useful. And these are the basic and foundation of accounting, right? So this is all about these two transactions.